pray for rain, as we know we desperately do need rain, as we are in a little deficit for the year. So again, just as a reminder, again, so who are we?
We are St. John's, growing to Jesus and spreading the saving grace.
So this morning, the sermon text is going to be on Exodus 19. And the reason for Exodus 19 is it kind of also ties into last week's text with maturing in faith, growing in faith, as again, the baptismal font. So Exodus 19 is a good reminder because Moses is talking to the Israelites. On the first day, he says, cleanse yourself. The second day, he says, refrain from being with a woman or being with women. And the third day, prepare yourself. So you think it applies to us. We don't live under the law, but we have the law written in our hearts. And thanks be to God, we have a Savior, Lord Jesus Christ, who has called us by name. He thinks the waters of holy baptism, we too have been cleansed. It's not only a cleansing whenever we feel like it, but it's a daily cleansing of all of our sins. And as we grow in our faith, we prepare ourselves too. So with that being said, we open service this morning with our opening hymn, hymn 672, Jerusalem the Golden.
Since we are gathered to hear God's word, called upon
respond in prayer and praise and receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in the fellowship of this altar, let us first consider our unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God, our Heavenly Father, seeking his grace for the sake of Christ and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Amen.
Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all of your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority, by the grace of God, your sins are forgiven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let all the peoples praise you.
Let the nations be glad and sing for joy.
For you judge the peoples of the equity and guide the nations on earth.
Let the peoples praise you, O God.
Let all the peoples praise you.
The earth has yielded its increase.
God, our God, shall bless us.
God shall bless us.
Let all the ends of the earth fear him.
Glory be to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thus you shall say to the house of Jacob, and tell the people of Israel, you yourselves have seen what I did to the Egyptians, and how I bore you on eagle's wings, and brought you to myself. Now therefore, if you will indeed obey my voice, and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession among all peoples. For all the earth is mine, and you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. These are the words that you shall speak to the people of Israel. So Moses came and called the elders of the people and set before them all these words the Lord had commanded him. All the people answered together and said, all that the Lord has spoken, we will do. And Moses reported the words of the people to the Lord. And the Lord said to Moses, behold, I am coming to you in a thick cloud, that the people may hear when I speak with you, and may also believe you forever. When Moses told the words of the people to the Lord said to Moses, go to the people and consecrate them today and tomorrow, and let them wash their garments, and be ready for the third day. For on the third day the Lord will come down on Mount Sinai in the sight of all the people. And you shall set limits for the people all around, saying, take care not to go up into the mountain or touch the edge of it. Whoever touches the mountain shall be put to death. No hand shall touch him, but he shall be stoned or shot. Whether beast or man, he shall not live. When the trumpet sounds a long blast, they shall come up to the mountain. So Moses went down from the mountain to the people and consecrated the people, and they washed their garments. And he said to the people, be ready for the third day, and do not go near a woman. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle is from Romans chapter 5. For while we were still weak, at the right time Christ died for the ungodly. For one will scarcely die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, one would dare even to die. But God shows his love for us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Since therefore we have now been justified by his blood, much more shall we be saved by him from the wrath of God. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more, now that we are reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. More than that, we also rejoice in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. Therefore, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men because all sinned. For sin indeed was in the world before the law was given, but sin is not counted where there is no law. Yet death reigned from Adam to Moses, even over those whose sinning was not like the transgression of Adam, who was a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not like the trespass. For if many died through one man's trespass, much more had the grace of God and the free gift by the grace of that one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for many. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Send out called to him his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits to cast them out and to heal every disease and every affliction. The names of the 12 apostles are these. First, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew his brother, James the son of Zebedee, and John his brother, Philip and Bartholomew, Thomas and Matthew the tax collector, James the son of Alphaeus and Theudas, Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out, instructing them, "Go nowhere amongst the Gentiles, and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, and proclaim as you go, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse lepers, cast out demons. You receive without paying. Give without pay, acquire no gold nor silver nor copper for your belts, nor bag for your journey, nor two tunics, nor sandals, nor a staff, for the laborer deserves his food. In whatever town or village you enter, find out who is worthy in it and stay there until you depart. As you enter the house, greet it. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it, but if it is not worthy, let your peace return to you. And if anyone will not receive you or listen to your words, shake off the dust from your feet when you leave that house or town. Truly, I say to you, it will be more bearable on the day of judgment for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah than for that town. Behold, I am sending you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. So be wise as serpents and innocent as doves. Beware of men, for they will deliver you over to courts and flog you in their synagogues. And you will be dragged before governors and kings for my sake, to bear witness before them and the Gentiles. When they deliver you over, do not be anxious how you are to speak or what you are to say. For what you are to say will be given to you in that hour. For it is not you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you." This is the Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Together we confess our common Christian faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. Together we confess.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance to the Father, having all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism of the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please be seated, and at this time I invite all the volunteers who will be serving this week for BBS to step forward up to the altar rail. Great to see many hands. As many hands, it makes work far easier, right? Say, you can scooch in the middle if you need to. All right, great to see everybody. Again, thank you everybody for serving this week at BBS. Just a short little installation of the BBS volunteers for this week. But again, this wouldn't be possible without your service. And as you serve the Lord, you're full of joy. And that joy reflects upon the kids this week. And that joy reflects upon the kids, not only upon you, but as you bring the word to them. As that's one of the missions of EBS, is to bring the word to the children. It's happening because sometimes this may be the only time during the summer they get to hear the word of God. You never know what difference you may see, but as we're full of joy as we go and serve the Lord, what a blessing we have. So thank you. As many hands makes it easy work. So at this time, I install each and every one of you as VBS volunteers this year as we serve the Lord, as we serve our community, as we serve our congregation, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Y'all may go back to your seats, and we continue with our hymn of the day, hymn 743, Jesus, Priceless Treasure.
Thank you.
grace, mercy, and peace be from God our Father, and our Savior and Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated. This morning, as we are reminded again, being in the season of Pentecost, the color green means growth. As we continue off of last week's sermon and carry on, you may think, why the Old Testament lesson? Because Exodus is full of the law. But you know what? We are not bound to the law, but we're still reminded of the law because the law is written on each and every one of our hearts. And that's why it reflects the sermon title, Listen, Obey, and Keep, which points us to our priceless treasure, Jesus' priceless treasure, of which we heard sung the words, sin that once did blind me, God leave far behind me. Thou art still my purest pleasure, Jesus' priceless treasure. And in the other text, we hear in the Romans text, especially towards the beginning, but the free gift is not like a trespass, for if many died through one man's trespass, much more have the grace of God, and the free gift by the grace of that one man, Jesus Christ, abounded for many. Which we are reminded, we are dead to sin and alive in Christ as we grow and mature in our faith, just as the gospel told to us. As when, especially towards the beginning of that, where it says, what is peace? Where do we receive peace? We receive peace from God our Father. Listening can be one of the most difficult skills for one to learn. Some of us might be saying, oh, 9 o'clock in the morning, I'm not up yet. I need my coffee. My caffeine hasn't kicked in. I can't listen yet, can I? Well, instead of actively listening, of which we all ought to do, we often listen passively, focusing on other things. Focusing perhaps on our Father's Day luncheon. Focusing on perhaps what's going to be happening this week. Focusing on perhaps our busy week of VBS. You see, if we don't listen actively, it affects our actions. And as it affects our actions, we oftentimes do the opposite. We don't follow Jesus and his ways. We often don't listen to Jesus. And sometimes we don't even talk about Jesus throughout our week. So we do the opposite when one is speaking to us in a serious tone, or if we are distracted. One may say, don't do this. What do? Of course you do the opposite. And you respond, well, you never told me so. We are all guilty of this just as much as the Israelites were when Moses, by authority from God, told them not to do these things, of which carries on in Exodus 20, which we see the Ten Commandments. And further on through the book of Exodus, do not do this, do not do that, do not do this. Carry on. What are the people doing? Are they listening? Or are they one ear up, not the other? Now, obeying a command can be just as difficult as listening, as how many of us can go back to our childhood, or even for the youth here, and remember a time when your mom, dad, or grandparents said, go do this. And you responded, but I don't have time for that. But I don't have to do that. Why? Why do I need to do that? We hear different variations of this excuse today when we are commanded to do something. And we hear the Israelites doing the same. And even the disciples were told, go. Did they always follow perfectly? Perhaps, but most likely, they didn't always follow perfectly. Because they said, but I don't have time for that. Now, keeping to a command can also become difficult, especially when we feel as if we can do better than what we are told. We often hear this one when one will say, I told you to do it this way. And we respond, well, I want to do it this way because my way is better. Or one will say, why did you do that when you knew it was wrong? And we respond, it wasn't my fault. He did it first. She did it first. It's not my fault. We hear this today and also from the Israelites. However, if we listen, obey, and keep not according to our own ways or wills, but God's, we will inherit a treasured possession. Will we fall short of expectations? More often than not. How many of us have always fallen short of expectations? Each and every one of us. Will we stumble? Definitely. Will it grow to be difficult? Always. But one thing we always will have is we will always have a calling to be faithful. And we can do so by placing our faith in God, who by the Spirit gives us strength. And by Jesus, we will be given guidance, leadership, correction, as he promises to be with us until the end of the age, as was portrayed in that in our hymn of the day, Jesus, Priceless Treasure, of which really is a sermon within a hymn. The disciples faced the situation too, to listen, obey, and keep. And this also applies to us today, even if we may not think so. Behold, I am sending you out as sheep in the midst of the wolves, so be wise as serpents and innocent as doves. We are called to serve the Lord. It is not through our strength that we will overcome, but from maturing in our faith. Moses sure didn't do it himself, as Jesus reminds us. For it is not you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you, of which will be reflected greatly this week during VBS as we reach the children of our congregation and as we reach the children of our community. But yet, we face a dilemma. The drama, the unending drama, the drama of distracting noises and ways. You see, the drama of life is distracting, and at times it feels as if it's like a black hole, constantly sucking us in. Constantly sucking the joy out of our lives. Now the Israelites earlier on in Exodus 14 had just been freed from the hostile hands of Pharaoh. This was the noise of rejoice. But yet we know, just like we are, they were still born of sin. And the back and forth battle would begin with grumbling and complaining. Do you mean I need to do it this way? Come on, I'm going to do it my way. But in context, Moses is warning to the Israelites to cleanse themselves and avoid pursuing any woman was setting the tone of God using Moses and the scene of God's people, turning away from God's commands as we see in Exodus 20, with the Ten Commandments being given to Moses from God to be delivered to the people. It wasn't Moses giving these commandments. It was God giving the commandments to Moses to deliver to the people, of which we too are commanded to listen, obey, and keep. The drama of rebellion is nothing new to man. The joke is always, how many of us have had teenagers? With teenagers come drama. With drama comes rebellion. I don't need to do that, Mom! I know what's right, I know what's wrong. We see Moses being sent from God, spoke on behalf of God's authority. Some truly listened, but some only halfway listened. They heard passively. This is like us too. We see this when we too have heard the same, when two have heard the same command to do. Let's just say siblings, sisters, brothers, brother, sister. Both hear it. Yet one says they heard it this way, and the other this way. Now, what does this cause, especially when you go into the world, when you have friends in the world? This way or that way? It causes a rift. Instead of following one, people end up becoming two. We see this in Exodus 32 with the golden calf when Moses had clearly heard God's instructions, whereas Aaron did not and built an altar with a golden calf. The battle of I'm right and you are wrong played out until the revelation of truth, which was laid upon Aaron when God threatened to lay out his wrath. wrath on the stiff-necked people. Is your neck a little stiff this morning?
Maybe.
Are you stubborn?
Maybe.
Did you not want to wake up?
Maybe.
But you know what? We're here. Thanks be to God, we're able to join. But the rebellion continues to this day, as we all see it each and every day. Through the Word of God, it is routinely mentioned to prepare ourselves and lay down our lives at the feet of the cross. Do we always do so? No. Why? Because we feel that we are accountable to the world. Or perhaps even we want to do what we want to do. We may even feel that our ways are better and we'll craft a path to success, happiness, and ease through our ways, through our earthly treasures, our possessions. But you know what? As we do that, it will always come crashing down until the revelation of truth hits that we need to return to God and our Christian faith. And as we listen, keep, and obey the ways and will of God, the truth comes clear from the words from God directly to the Israelites. You yourselves have seen what I did to the Egyptians and how I bore you on eagle's wings and brought you to myself. Now therefore, if you indeed obey my voice and keep my covenant, you shall be my treasured possession among all peoples. For the nation, for the all the earth is mine, and you shall be to me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. You see, these are the words that you shall speak to the people of Israel. The drama of truth comes crashing down when there are consequences, but we learn and grow from the drama of life. As we're reminded again, green means growth. We grow from our mistakes. And as we grow from our mistakes, we grow in our faith. As we grow in our faith, we share our faith with one another. We mentor one another. We reach out to one another with care, concern, compassion. And the drama of truth is the revelation that we all need to embrace. Jesus' words give us lessons. Lessons that will continue today and tomorrow and the coming months, as in August and September, you will hear more about the parables in Matthew that teach us to embrace God's way and God's will. If you go back into Scripture, life was not a cakewalk and it had many difficulties. You may say, if only we can go back, wouldn't it be nice to live 100, 200, 300 years of life? Wouldn't it be nice just to live that life? You see, through the foundation of faith, knowing where true treasure was, they turned back to God. And as we too realize the truth, we come to further reality that we have a God of grace, a God of mercy, and a God of love, who truly is the rock of ages, who will never abandon us, even as we sin. For those who repent, the reality of treasure possession exists. Today you heard the words of absolution, not from me, but from God. By the grace of God, your sins have been forgiven. That means your sins have been cleansed. Where are you reminded of that? Baptism. Where are you reminded of that today? Holy Communion. And this very reality of treasure possession begins with our baptismal life. As we are reminded through the very waters that the old Adam is drowned. The old Adam is beaten and killed. And the new Adam comes to life where we are dead to sin and alive in Christ. And in this new Adam that we have been given our identity because of Christ's sacrifice for you and the world and the cross, his descent into hell and the ascension of the dead, sin has been conquered by Christ. You have been reconciled. That means brought back together. That unconditional sacrifice that Christ has given to you gives you the assurance of treasure, possession. You gain this not by your own doing, ways, or wills, but through God's will, through his endless grace towards each and every one of us, his heavenly children. And as we listen to God's promises given to us through the Word and given to us through the means of grace, we are guaranteed of our baptismal identity when we approach the altar for a blessing or to receive his body and blood, knowing that we have been forgiven. Or even today we saw the VBS volunteers come up and receive the blessing. Or as we will pray for them in the prayers of the church, knowing that they are blessed. And as they deliver the word of God, it is nothing but treasure to the children's ears. For we will not listen, obey, or keep to perfection. But we have grace, as wherever forgiveness of sins is offered, love is present. This love is the love that God gave to the Israelites, who fell routinely, but then turned back to God. This love is given to us today, even as we may be broken, distraught, grief-stricken, and hurting. We will be redirected, and we will be guided, given strength by the Spirit to genuinely listen, obey, and keep. And as we prepare, growing pains will occur. Some limbs may need to be pruned, but you know what? Life lessons will be gained, and we will grow as we grow in Christ, as we grow in our faith, as we mature in our faith. And as we learn from them, we will grow wise with wisdom, being rooted in your faith. And we will be ready to be cast into the world as sheep in the midst of wolves. And as we live and die for Christ, each and every day, living according to God's good and gracious will, placing our trust in God most just, we will be made holy. And we know as we live by faith, as we walk by faith, we will be declared righteous by God, who desires and promises for us who walk faithfully life and salvation through Jesus, our priceless treasure, our rock, and our salvation, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Amen. And now may the peace of God, who surpasses all understanding, may guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus unto life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated, and at this time, as we gather our tithes and our offerings, please fill out the fellowship pad at the end of your pew and the aisle side, and please pass it down so we can get an accurate attendance, and so that if you're visiting us today, we can welcome you, as we'd like to welcome any of you who are visiting with us today, as you are always welcome. And as we also gather our tithes and offerings, please always be in prayer. Reflect in prayer as we pray for our community, as we pray for our state, as we pray for our nation and world. To not turn to the world, but to turn their face back to God.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God. Send forth laborers to make known the gospel of your kingdom in Christ Jesus. Prosper the labor of all pastors, missionaries, and all church workers, and especially all volunteers of the church, especially this week as we pray for all of our VBS volunteers and all of our VBS participants this week, that many people may hear, believe, and praise you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O righteous Father, from whom all fatherhood in heaven and earth is named, give your grace to the fathers and sons of your church. Inspire them by your own example and the example of your beloved Son to be perfectly united in faith, hope, and love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord, turn the eyes of all who make, execute, and judge our laws to you, that they may receive wisdom and strength to faithfully carry out their duties. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O God, our God, the earth still yields its increase under your care and preservation. Bless us with daily bread, and continue to bless our land with much needed rain, and give us wisdom as stewards of your creation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, your Son demonstrated his power over sin by healing every disease and affliction. Give healing to those in need. Doris Buzzard, Eleanor Erickson, Nancy Erickson, Pastor Wolf, Todd France, Bob Edmonds, Dwayne Lovett, Nate Mosbaugh, Jim Anders, Barb Willing, all who are homebound, and all who we name in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Lord of hosts, you descended on Mount Sinai and bid Moses to come into your presence. Prepare the hearts of all who come to your altar today, that they may receive Christ's body and blood for their forgiveness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O blessed Lord, through Moses, you called a people to yourself, and from them you delivered up your own Son to be called to be our Savior. By his sufferings and death, he has redeemed us sinners from our sins. By his resurrection, he has released us from the fear of death. Help us to live as your people, doing the good works for which we were created, and praying with confidence and petitions and supplications of our hearts. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is truly meet, right, and salutary that we should at all times and all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who out of love for his fallen creation humbled himself by taking on the form of a servant, becoming obedient unto death, even death upon a cross. Risen from the dead, he has freed us from eternal death and given us life everlasting. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing. Promised salvation by a second Adam, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. and made his cross a life-giving tree for all who trust in him. We give you thanks for the redemption you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Grant us your Holy Spirit that we may faithfully eat and drink of the fruits of his cross and receive the blessings of forgiveness, life, and salvation that come to us in his body and blood. Hear us as we pray in his name and as he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.